Hi my dear students, in this video we are going to see grade 5 EVS chapter 4. Before entering into the chapter, let me ask one question. Which is our national fruit? Yes, we everyone know our national fruit is mango. So the chapter name also related to that only, mangoes round the year. Why the name comes like this, mangoes round the year? At the end of the chapter, you will come to know why they have given the name for this chapter. And here some introduction they are given. Some conversation between friends. They are talking among themselves while they are eating lunch in school. One friend, he brought potato sabji. After he opened, he is saying that my potato sabji is spoiled. How he came to know that potato sabji is spoiled? Can you able to and see the answer for this question? Yes, we can able to know from the smell, right? From the texture, from the smell. Smell will be somewhat different. If it is spoiled, the smell will be somewhat different. And have you ever seen some food has been spoiled like this before? Just recall yourself whether you have seen any food material spoiled like this. And if that friend eat that potato sabji, what will happen to him? Maybe stomach pain or vomiting or some food poison also may be happened to him. And here they have listed out something. What are the food materials that can be spoiled within 2 to 3 days? Let me give some examples, and after I am giving some examples, you also want to shout out some examples. So, which are the food materials that can be spoiled between 2 to 3 days? Whatever it is, food we are cooking, sambars, right, poriyals what we are cooking, then milk, curd, everything it may be spoiled within 2 or 3 days. And which are the food items that can be kept for a week without spoiling? For week, for example, I can give some examples. Vegetables and fruits which we are purchasing from market, bread items, like these things we can keep for a week. I'm giving some examples. You also want to write some examples here. And which are the food items we can keep without spoiling for 1 month? For example, I'm giving some examples like jam, ketchup and many things. You also want to make a list for this, which are the food items may be wasted from 2 to 3 days for a week and after 1 month, right? Okay, for example, I'm going to give one example for you. If your mother is asking to buy one bread packet from supermarket and she is giving you some money, you are going to supermarket, what and all you will see in the packet? Suddenly you will purchase the bread and come? No, you want to see something. What are the things you will see? Sure, everyone want to see the expiry date, right? If today it is 18-9, right? If the expiry date is 17-9, will you brought that bread to your home? No, sure, it is already expired. The fungus may be formed in the bread. So, you should not purchase that. So, from hereafter, if your mom is giving you money and asking you to purchase something from the shop, you want to see in the wrapper whether it is expired or not. The expiry date is not only for tablets but also for food items. You want to see the expiry dates. So while you are going for supermarket, you want to look on to the packet that whether the food is expired or the date is there, like that you want to check. Here they have given some examples, some experiments, right? So you are going to take one piece of bread or roti and sprinkle some few drops of water in that and put in a box. And daily you are going to observe that what happened to the bread, and you are going to fill this chart. Okay, first day by touch what happened, what will be the smell and what will be the color and what will be the smell, like that you want to observe everything and you want to write in the chart. How it will be? What happens if you are keeping the bread continuously for one week? For example, continuously for 1 week you are keeping the bread in a box. What happens? black color, something will be happen, color will change, the bread will become hard, the color will be changing to black, and the smell will be, it won't be not nice, right? What happened? The fungus may be form in the bread. The fungus happened due to that pores, small openings will be there, you can see in the bread. The small openings will be there in the bread, no? In that the fungus may enter inside the bread and it will spoil the bread completely. It is otherwise, the fungus is otherwise called as mold. It will enter through that holes in the bread and it will spoil the bread completely. So just after doing this, you want to wash your hands. So what is a general tip to make the bread safe for some extra days? If you want to keep the bread for 2 more days, what is the general tip you want to follow? Here I am going to give one general tip, that you want to store this bread in cold and dark place. You should not keep the bread in high temperature like hot or in very bright places. You want to store the bread in dark and cold places, right? So that the bread, it will extend for 2 more days. It won't spoil for another 2 more days. That is a general tip I am giving here. Here in your book, they gave many examples how to preserve milk, cooked rice, many food materials for extra storage, extra fresh. Keep fresh for 2 or more days extra. Okay, for milk, what can we do? You can preserve the milk in a container of water so that you can keep the milk fresh for more than 1 day. And cooked rice, you can wrap it in a cloth. And green coriander, you can boil that so that it may be fresh for extra 1 day. And onion and garlic, whatever you are purchasing from market, big onion, small onion, potatoes, garlic, everything, you should not store in fridge or in any dark places. You want to store this onion in open and dry places so that it will be fresh for more than 1 week. These are the small tips they have given in your book to make your fruit fresh extra for some days. Here in your book, they have given you one story about mango. That summer treat. Chitti Babu and Chinna Babu, they are small boys, brothers like you. They are living in Andhra Pradesh. And they are spending their summer holidays in mango garden and they are playing in that mango garden. While they are playing, they are taking some mangoes from that mango tree. That is unripe mangoes, and they are eating that mangoes with some salts and chili powders. And their mom, she will also cook that unripe mangoes into different ways, like mango pickles, like that, etc. And after returning to home, these boys, they are asking to mom that, mom, can you able to prepare mamidi tandra, that is arm puppet. In our state, we used to say this like mango jelly. Natural, we will eat, no? Mango jelly. All the children, they used to eat this. They like this more, mango jelly. So they are asking their mom to prepare this mango jelly, arm puppet. Their father, he is saying that, so it is not easy to prepare that arm puppet. It is very tough. It is tough to prepare that mango jelly. For that, you want to help. You want to promise that you both will help me every day to prepare that arm puppet or mango jelly. Like that, he is saying. So these brothers, they are agreeing and promising to their father that sure, we will help you in preparing this arm puppet. Like that, they are saying. And they went to market next day with their father and they are purchasing palm leaves and jangri powder and jangri sugar, etc. for making this arm puppet. And first the father is taking all the ripe mangoes. Why he is taking all the ripe mangoes first? Palutha mammalangal. Why he is taking that first? Because it may be spoiled easily. Right, first the mangoes, ripe mangoes will spoil easily than the unripe mangoes. He is taking all the ripe mangoes first. And they are converting that mango into a pulp. And the pulp is applied into a small cloth, muslin cloth. It is a type of cloth. They are applying that mango pulp into that cloth. So before applying that mango pulp, they are mixing that mango pulp with jaggery and sugar. Why they are adding the jaggery and sugar? Without jaggery or sugar, if they are using the plain mango pulp, the mango jelly, it won't be very sugary and it won't be very tasty. If the sugar is added, sugar content is added only, children will like most.
otherwise it will be somewhat bitter. So they are adding some jaggery powder and sugar powder inside that mango pulp, and they are spreading that pulp in a cloth. And second day, again they are preparing some mango pulp. The first layer of the pulp becomes somewhat dry. Okay, now they are applying the second layer again by using the same process, by adding jaggery, sugar, etc. Like this, 4 or 5 days, they are adding 3 or 4 layers to that. And after 2 or 3 weeks, they are getting this mango pulp, or you can say that they are getting that mango jelly or aam papad. So now it is ready. So how much hard work it is needed to prepare a mango, and this mango aam papad, you can keep this mango jelly for even 1 year, it won't spoil, because after many process we are converting this into an food, that item. So it won't spoil for at least for 1 year. You can see in natural pocket or in mango jelly pocket, they will give expiry date very long days, like 1 year or 6 months, like that they will give. So throughout the year you can eat this mango. So only the chapter name is Mangoes Around the Year. So now give me some food items that can be used without spoiling for 1 year with the help of mango. What are the food items you can prepare with the help of mango? So I can give some examples like mango pickle, aam papad, etc. You can also find some examples like this. Here they are discussing about some questions, right? Whether you have gone through any pickle that is made in your house, and what kind of pickle you have made. Whether your mom made any pickle in your home, and how will you preserve that? If you are, most of the people used to preserve all the pickles in the bottles. So before you putting that pickles into the bottles, completely the bottles are dried up. That should not be any water content in the bottles. Otherwise the pickle won't be nice for more than 1 year. It will be spoiled quickly. So we want to dry the bottle and we want to store the pickle inside. And what are the necessary materials, necessary resources, things needed to make a pickle? Chili powder, oil, and vegetable. What are the pickle you are going to make? If you are going to make a mango pickle, you want mango. Like that, salt, everything. We want to make that recipe. And if you are going for a journey in a train for 2 or 3 days, what are the food items you will carry with you that won't spoil for 2 or 3 days? Maximum people, they will carry chapati, right? Like this, many rices also, it won't spoil for 2 or 3 days. They will carry like this food items with them. So that if you want to enjoy the mango for a full year, you can get mango only in the summer season. But during the time we can store that mango, we can create many food materials from that mango, like pickles, aam papad, like that, and you can enjoy that mango for throughout the year. Because most of us like mango, children's also, most of us used to eat this mango often. So you can prepare this mango pickle or aam papad when you are getting the mango in the mango season, and you can preserve it for 1 year. So that here the chapter ends, Mangoes Around the Year. You can get the mangoes only in the summer season, but you can prepare variety of food materials from mango and you can preserve it for 1 year. That's all about this chapter 4, Mangoes Around the Year. Thank you, dears.